One method to model non-ideal reactors is to use a number of CSTRs in series, n being the number that we can vary to best fit the non-ideal reactor. And the volume of each CSTR is just the total volume of the non-ideal reactor divided by n. If we have a small number of CSTRs, in extreme 1, of course it's a model of a CSTR, if we have a very large number of CSTRs, then it approaches the model of a plug flow reactor. And so in between, then it allows us by picking n to get a better approximation for reactor than just modeling something as an ideal reactor. And if we're going to do that, we can use resonance time distribution measurements to determine the value of n so that the resonance time distribution from a number of CSTRs in series, which is calculated in a different video, matches the resonance time distribution of the non-ideal reactor. And so once we know n for our system, we can calculate the conversion for this non-ideal reactor by solving sequentially the balances for the CSTR. Namely, we're looking at a steady state system, and the first CSTR, steady state, the volumetric flow rate n times the concentration in the feed, so let's call that CA0, CA1, CA2, CA3, CAN-1, CAN. Volumetric flow rate in, volumetric flow rate times the concentration leaving. And let's look at a first order reaction. Concentration reactor is also the concentration 1 times the volume of the reactor. So we're assuming constant density. If we're modeling this as liquid phase, we don't have to make that assumption. We can certainly solve it where the density could vary. And we can rewrite this equation to simplify it, dividing through by the volumetric flow rate. So we end up with the space-time, the volume of the reactor. In this case, remember, volume V for given reactor is the total volume of our non-ideal reactor divided by N. Well, we can write the same kinds of equation for the second reactor. So the second CSTR, again, steady state, no accumulation. CA1 now is the feed, CA2 is leaving, reaction occurring at concentration CA2, and the same value for tau. And of course, then in general, CAN-1, CAN, KCAN, tau. So keeping in mind that the concentration in the reactor is the same as the concentration leaving the reactor. So this means that if we solve these equations, CA1 is CA0, 1 plus K times tau. CA2 is CA1, 1 plus K tau. So this means CAN in general, CA0, 1 plus K times tau to the nth power. So this is, of course, for a first-order reaction. We model a non-ideal reactor for first-order reaction by a series of CSTRs, namely n CSTRs. Tau is the volume of the individual reactor divided by the volumetric flow rate, or the total volume divided by n, the number of CSTRs times the volumetric flow rate. CA0 is the entering concentration. This, then, is the concentration leaving the nth reactor. Well, we can write these same equations down for second order, third order, and go through the solutions. The idea, the concept is the same. We're modeling a real reactor that's non-ideal, has a series of CSTRs, very large number of CSTRs. It's going to look close to a plug flow reactor. Very small number of CSTRs, it approaches, of course, an ideal CSTR.